Hello, in today's video, I'm sharing some underrated beauty products that I think you need to know about. In the sea of viral beauty products that we hear about constantly, I think it's refreshing to hear about some lesser talked about beauty products that are fantastic. I like to do these videos periodically because I have an entire list of products that I think are underrated and really great and just don't get enough love. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new, and let's go ahead and get into these products that I think are underrated. I'm pretty makeup focused today, except for this first segment. I have a sunscreen and a couple of skincare products I've been using consistently over the past couple of months. They've worked really well for my sensitive skin, so well that I ran out of the serum and had to grab another bottle because I just didn't want to be without it. I've shared two of these products with you before and how much I had been liking them. I continue to love them, think they're underrated. I want to thank Elastin for partnering with me on this portion of the video. I would have had these products in this video anyway. They're a perfect fit because I think Elastin overall is completely underrated. So let's first talk about the sunscreen. This is their Hydra Tint Pro Mineral Sunscreen. It has broad spectrum UVA, UVB, SPF 36 protection. I'm always very, very skeptical of mineral sunscreens because I have very sensitive skin, and a lot of times they can be very heavy, make me greasy during the day. If you have very dry skin, sometimes they can dry your skin out as the day goes on. They can also leave a white cast. That's why a lot of people are tinting their sunscreens now. You can see on the back of my hand, this tint is darker than what my skin appears to be on my face. This is a lightweight formula. It blends into the skin so easily, so quickly. It evens out my skin tone in such a great way, and it's not too dark for my skin. Now, I have light medium skin tone, so keep that in mind. If you're someone who doesn't like a tinted sunscreen, they do have an untinted version on the website. I'll have both linked down below along with everything in this video. This has become a go-to sunscreen for me because it just evens out things so nicely and feels so lightweight. It wears well under makeup. It doesn't make me greasy during the day. It also has antioxidants in it and blue light protection too. Now let's talk about the Restorative Complex Serum that I'm on my second bottle of. Now keep in mind, Elastin is a medical grade skincare brand. Now as someone who has used other medical grade skincare brands before, I have some experience with that. I have seen a difference with medical grade skincare, and I know there's a lot of people who aren't quite sure if there's a big difference between over-the-counter skincare and medical grade. In a big nutshell, medical grade skincare is designed to penetrate the skin more deeply than over-the-counter skincare. There's a lot more science, a lot more technology involved, and clinical trials are actually taking place, rigorous testing, so that their products can be FDA approved. You don't get that with over-the-counter skincare. There are some other things too, but for me as a consumer of beauty products, of skincare, those are the things that stand out to me the most. So from the first moment I put this on my face, I just fell in love with the texture. It's this very lightweight, milky lotion that just seemed to absorb into my skin in such a beautiful way. It takes time to see results from skincare products, but what I noticed right off the bat was that my skin seemed to almost absorb my moisturizing products more. My skin seemed less dehydrated, less parched. It just felt better. And the longer I kept using it, I started realizing that my skin seemed less reactive, less sensitive. My skin tone seemed better. It seemed smoother, softer. The more that I use it, it just looks more hydrated and more plump. This is supposed to improve the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. It's supposed to help with the volume in the skin and increase the elasticity and help with darkness and uneven skin tone. I mean, I'm 46. I know a lot of you are my age or you're older, and those are all things that we can benefit from. And I've been loving this. I mean, like I said, I'm on my second bottle. I know neck creams are a really polarizing topic for people, so I'm gonna keep this pretty brief, but I do wanna touch on the Restorative Neck Complex. Every now and then, I'll just get kind of splotchy on my neck out of nowhere. I can't use my facial treatment products, the glycolic acids, my prescription tretinoin. I can't bring that down on my neck. So I like to use creams that are specifically made for the neck area because they're made for that sensitive skin, which is sensitive on a lot of people. They're made to thoroughly moisturize while also treating and addressing signs of anti-aging. This has a thicker texture than this, but it's still really lightweight. It's not heavy or sticky. It nourishes and moisturizes this area really well. I can get really dry underneath my chin area, and this helps that a lot. And it also helps address the crepey skin, discoloration, all that stuff. But I've noticed that I have not had those red spots like I usually get. I have not had a reactive neck area. It's been looking really smooth. So I burned myself pretty badly with a curling iron about a month ago, right around this area. I can't even see it anymore. I'm not sure exactly where it was. I mean, I haven't done that in years and it's scabbed over. You know what I'm talking about? Have you ever done that? It's horrible. And then you have to go around and explain yourself. I burned myself with a curling iron. I just knew that when that scab came off, it was going to leave a huge red mark that was going to stay there forever. In the past, that's what's happened. It's pretty much invisible now. My skin doesn't heal faster the older I get. We get thinner skin, less elastic skin. And because these products are really great to use post-procedure and in your daily life, I know that this is why it healed so quickly. Elastin has a full skincare line to maintain your daily skin health, as well as to enhance aesthetic procedures if you happen to get any of those. If you're interested in seeing more, I do have a code for you where you can save some money. So I did my last underrated beauty products video about a month ago, and I really struggled as to whether I should put the Persona lip liners or the lip glosses in that video. In the end, I went with the lip glosses, but I have to mention Persona lip liners in this video because these are lip liners that I use on a daily basis, on the regular. Yes, this one is broken. Your eyes are not deceiving you. This is one of my favorite neutral shades too. I need to get another. This is called Almond. The shade that you're seeing me apply in the clip is Dusk, which is a great neutral pink. If you're someone who maybe didn't want to spend the money on Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk, I think this would be a great option. It's not an exact dupe, but it's just a great neutral pink, rosy lip liner that's not too pink. I mean, I think all of her shades are really nice and wearable, but more than that, it's about the formula. As I get older, I find it harder to find lip liners that don't drag on my lips as I apply them or accentuate my vertical lip lines or make me feel dry after I apply them. These Persona lip liners glide on the lips so beautifully, and they don't emphasize any bad texture. I don't get bleeding from them. They also don't settle in so that they make my lips feel dry. The liner itself is so comfortable that I could just wear the liner and I would be fine, but they also help other products last longer. And you know, that's kind of the goal for me for lip liners, because I do fill in my lips, and I will talk about what I have on over this here in a second, but these needed a spot here because I just don't think these get the recognition that they deserve. It's been a while since I've talked about the blush I have on today. Not the particular color, although that will be mentioned too, but the formula, the product itself. There are probably some of you here on my channel that have never heard me mention the Daniel Sandler watercolor blushes. This is probably my favorite liquid blush formula. It is just no fail. So the other main person I hear talk about these is Shelby Wilson. I'll link her channel down below. This is not a brand that is offered at mass retailers like Sephora, like Ulta. They are at other retailers. I'll have a couple options listed down below. I like to drop a couple of drops onto the back of my hand and then dip my brush into it. I'll also list the brush I use all the time to apply this, as well as other liquid and cream cheek products. I like to swirl it around on the back of my hand until it's probably, I guess, about 50 or 60% of the way dry or absorbed into the brush. I just don't want that brush being too wet when I go to apply this to my cheek. So you're seeing me apply this today over my powder, which for many liquid and cream blush formulas is kind of a no-no because it will remove what's underneath it. It will stick to those powder products and lift them up and kind of remove your makeup that you've applied. This doesn't do that. It just applies so beautifully. Sometimes when I think a blush is not going to remove the makeup and then I go to apply a little bit on my nose, it's a look, it's a thing. I know some people don't do it. It'll take it off my nose. This doesn't do that either. These are the easiest no-fail liquid blushes. The shade that I have on today is called Caress. I'll list a couple of other shades down below that I really like too. I don't think you can go wrong. And they last all day, no matter if you apply them over or between your makeup layers. This is such a good product. I just think everyone should know about them, try them. If you're someone who's tried liquid blush before and you just didn't get along with it, this might be the way to go, the thing to try now. So I think I've said that this product was underrated in other videos, but I've never put it in an underrated product video. And it is so very underrated and from a mainstream brand. I don't quite understand. This is the Shiseido Wasso Poreless Matte Primer. I've talked about this several times and I love it, but I just don't see a lot of people talking about it. But the people that do talk about it Love it. Now, this isn't like most matte primers, at least not for me. And I feel like the people that love this would agree. Most matte primers don't get along well with any dehydrated areas that you have usually. This one has something in it that also helps hydrate the skin. So while you're cutting down on shine, you're not depleting your skin of the needed moisture that it requires. So I can apply this all over my face if I want, or I can spot prime more in my T-zone where I tend to get more shine. That's usually what I do. It never makes my skin feel dry or tight, which can happen. Even with combination skin, I can feel dry and tight and just not right from mattifying primers. It feels like nothing. It keeps my shine away all day while not dehydrating my skin. I think what is off-putting to some people is the size. This is not the same size as most other bottles of primer, but you need half as much. I use a pea-size amount of other primers, which is plenty of any primer. I need about a half a pea-size amount of this one. A little bit goes a long way. It's got this unique formula to it that just really works. So even if you're someone with normal or even dry skin, you tend to have some shiny areas as the day goes on, this is a great one to check out if you haven't already. I don't understand why I'm not hearing more about these Mineralist lip gloss balms from Bare Minerals. I think these are absolutely fantastic. I don't understand what makes some products just hit and everyone talk about them while other ones just kind of hang out there and sit under the radar. And again, people that love them really love them. I am one of them. I just think these feel so good and they last a decent amount of time. And you're not just getting a lip gloss, you're not just getting a lip balm, you get a decent amount of pigment. I mean, the color that I had on the entire video until I put the wrong color on to reapply before this segment was called Love. It's this cool tone shade. So throughout the video, that's what I had on and I did not reapply it. I had it on over the Persona lip liner and I was drinking my coffee. I think for my lips to have looked that good for having on just lip liner plus a gloss is pretty incredible. So what I accidentally replaced it with, this more neutral pink, is called Heat. Now, I think in my September favorites video, I'll link that down below because I had some great products in there and some really big duds in the video too. I talked about the shade Adventure, which looks like just a big fat no. This is so pretty on. It's just striking. I never ever would have thought this would look the way it does once you put it on the lips. There are more shades to choose from too than just what I'm showing you. I think they have quite a few more shades. If you're looking for a product to keep your lips nourished, to treat your lips and give you some color, something easy to swipe on, I don't think you can go wrong with these and I don't know why I'm not hearing about them more. I think when this goes live, Bare Minerals is having a sale too. If they are, I'll have that link down below. These have been huge hits for me. I wear them all the time. I'll have my September favorites and fails video linked here, as well as my most recent makeup dupes video if you haven't seen those. I'd love to hear your underrated products that you've discovered down below. And if you enjoy drugstore underrated products, I do videos on those separately. So be sure you're subscribed if you're not already and become part of the family. I hope you found this video enjoyable and helpful. If you did, I'd appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.